This tutorial is designed to help you fix your Xbox 360 using the X-Clamp replacement method. Part 2, X-Clamp removal and replacement, heat sink cleaning, and Red Ring of Death fix. You'll need the tools from Part 1, a tube of heat sink grease, a bottle of alcohol, and a CD or DVD or some other plastic you can use to scrape with. You also need a pair of utility pliers. The cleaner you'll see me using in this is a Precision Electronics cleaner. You can pick it up at Radio Shack for about $10. Okay, the required hardware is 8 M5 metric screws, 16 1mm nylon washers, and 16 1mm metal washers. A kit containing all of those parts, including the Torx 10 and Torx 8 drivers and the heatsink compound, can be found on eBay for around $7. Once your Xbox motherboard is free from the case, begin by removing the X-clamps on the bottom of the Xbox motherboard. Start by prying each corner carefully, and with a minimum amount of pressure, they should pop loose. Take your time, as the motherboard is very sensitive and can be scratched easily. Remove the heatsink by gently pulling up on it. Remove the other heatsink in a similar fashion. Next, we must remove the heatsink bonding material that is on the bottom of the heatsink. Use your CD or some other kind of scraping device, possibly a credit card, and scrape as much as you can off the bottom of the heatsink. This electronics cleaner that I'm using is very, very strong and is very fast at cleaning these heatsinks. The alcohol may take more cleaning time than the electronics cleaner, that's why I use it. Repeat the process on the CPU heatsink. Making sure to remove all of the existing heatsink bonding material. Next, you'll want to clean both of the chips in the Xbox motherboard, this being the CPU and GPU chips. Make sure that all remnants of the heatsink interface material are completely gone. You'll know this by the top of the chips being very shiny. Next, take your tube of heatsink grease, which is also available at Radio Shack for around $3, and apply a very small amount to all three dies. There'll be two on the GPU and there'll be one on the CPU. Just put a small amount on each chip, probably the size of a BB on the main two chips and half that size on the small chip. Take your utility pliers and back out the studs that are in the heatsinks. These will be replaced by the screws later. Before the next step, take each of the 8 screws you have and slide onto each screw a steel washer and a nylon washer. The nylon washer is there to protect the motherboard from the pressure of the steel washer. flip the motherboard over and in each one of the holes for the GPU heatsink, put one of the screws with the washers attached. Place your hand over all four screws to hold them in place and flip the motherboard over. On each one of the screws on the top of the motherboard, place a nylon washer and then a steel washer. Again, the nylon washer is there to protect the motherboard from the pressure of the steel washer. Once all the washers are in place, place the heatsink on the top of the screws. Then while firmly pressing the heatsink to the motherboard, quickly flip the motherboard over. Next, screw each screw in to just about hand tight. Repeat this process for the CPU heatsink. Next, flip your motherboard around, plug in the power board, plug in the AV cable and the power cables. Turn your Xbox on with no fan attached. At this point, your Xbox may turn on and attempt to act normal, but it's not quite fixed yet. This stage is the overheating stage, and it can take anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes. You touch your heatsink and it's almost too hot to touch, then it's just about ready. Go ahead and turn your Xbox off. It may flash two lights, as here. That means it's overheating. Quickly unplug the AV cables and the power cable, and gently pull the motherboard up and tighten the GPU heatsink screws another quarter turn. This will ensure even tight pressure down on the GPU chip. Set the motherboard down gently and let it cool for no less than 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, hook the fan back up, your AV cables, and your power cable, and turn your Xbox on. At this point, your motherboard should be repaired. Go ahead and reassemble your Xbox. If you need help with this, you can watch part one in reverse. Once reassembled, turn your Xbox on. And your Red Ring of Death should be 100% completely repaired. Thank you for listening, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask.